Hello, my precious.
Wow, that's a really difficult question. I mean, as you say, I've had some really great opportunities and played some really interesting roles. And two roles really stick out. Well, obviously, one is Gollum because that really changed for me the direction of my career as an actor and opened up the whole world of acting using performance capture technology, which enabled me to play so many other roles. So, and just as a character in its own right, it was very complicated and psychologically complex and physically demanding. It was a wonderful role to play. But also the other role that I've really loved playing is Caesar in the Planet of the Apes trilogy, because it's incredibly rare for an actor to get the chance to play a part all the way from the birth of the character through its life to the end over the course of three movies. That was a real challenge, and obviously an evolving ape who his intelligence grows, he becomes more human-like in the way that he thinks and feels, and so that was very, very. I loved making those movies. I mean, when you step into a role like Alfred, obviously there have been so many awesome performances of Alfred before, not least Michael Caine. So the way that Matt approached the role, and which is why I think he wanted me to play it, was that there was a very emotional side to Alfred, an emotional relationship with Bruce, and. And yet there's a sense that he is also very capable. He would have been the equivalent of someone who worked for the royal family or someone like that, and then ended up working for the Wayne Enterprises. But crucially, the relationship that he has with Bruce is he's unable to be the father figure that he wishes he could be for him, because he doesn't know how to be a parent. But he cares for him enormously and feels so guilty because he wasn't there for him in his hour of need when that's his job. So he carries that guilt with him. And that kind of schism in the character, I think, is what that richness that Matt Reeves brought to the writing. And that's what I tried to bring to the role. I think in terms of the complexity was probably Caesar, actually, in the sense that, you know, he evolves physically and vocally, and there was a lot of kind of you know, there is an his emotional intelligence was always there, but with the enhancement of the Alzheimer's drug, the ALZ drug, that then affects his cognitive skills. It was always a real challenge as to how quickly and how human he would become throughout the course of the evolution of the stories. And so really sort of piecing that together and making sure that, you know, he didn't speak too fluently. There might be a line that you could cross where it suddenly the believability breaks. And that's why you know, we really painstakingly, and I painstakingly, kind of worked at how to moderate that so it felt believable at all times. Well, perhaps I can talk about my favourite films. I mean, my all-time favourite film is Apocalypse Now. I remember seeing it when I think I was about 14 years old in 70mm at the cinema, and it was literally one of the greatest cinematic experiences I've ever had. Always stuck with me. I also love Jane Campion's film The Piano. I remember seeing that at a point in my life where I was beginning to direct, and I just found it so inspirational. I just thought, and also it featured New Zealand, crucially, which is. Became my second home for a long time. The other film that I love, I do like musicals, actually, and Cabaret is for me one of the most brilliant kind of marriages of storytelling and musical entertainment, and great songs, and yet, you know, there's a really important story underlying it. So those are my three films.
One last request: would you mind looking at the camera and asking people to watch you on top motion?
Hello, my precious. Come and watch me, Andy Serkis, or Venom, in top motion.